What is real eye, you will understand. Are you clear? Did you understand what I am saying right now? Tell me example. Give me example. Give me, tell me.
Example.
Not example. Tell me, what did you understand?
The whole thing.
Huh.
So initially we are trying to do that. I forgot that I should play, I should be like that, and then
see
totally.
I can either you can make life as a play or life as a work. The moment life as a work, it becomes stressful. The moment life is a play, okay, you play the role very well. Sometimes it's dangerous, sometimes it's painful, but you play. So when you say play, it means hobby. Okay, so the choice of converting a work into a hobby is your choice, right? Or hobby into also work can become work. So because you have to make a living, you don't have much choice. Learn how to convert a work into a hobby. There's no point in crying every day, okay? There's no point. No point of time work will be less than 12 hours. I have worked for 30 years in my life, okay? It is sometimes 12 hours or 14 hours a day for 7 days a week. That's the nature of industry. So they'll say, if you can't, Divya can't do, somebody else will come do. So for your living, you have to do. Otherwise you decide, no, even if I die, I don't do work. That's okay. Any husband is there. What for husband is there, right?
He's also crying.
So he's also crying.
So both of them together.
But what I'm saying is, why? What is the point of crying every day about the job?
Yeah.
Okay. Right. So learn how to convert the job into a play by not becoming the role. Okay. The best example I give you, how a newly married woman becomes a wife. Trouble.
Becoming wife only, newly married, it is too complicated.
yeah, after becoming wife, it's all routine and monotonous, right?
No, for me, it's
convenient.
Now it is uncomfortable for him, it says. So what I'm saying is, when you are playful, okay, you have more choices in life, right? See, if I become a very serious guru, okay, oh my God, I have to be very daddy and I cannot smile. Then people will think me, oh, what is this fellow, his guru? Okay. I cannot, I have to only quote Sanskrit slokas, which you can't understand, neither I can understand. Right? So I can make your life miserable. My life was miserable. But right now, I am very relaxed and playful because I know it's a play. It's a role. Okay? Anybody who takes the role very seriously creates a problem in life for himself and others. So work will be 10 hours or 12 hours. Your boss will keep demanding because it's his role, right? And Rama and Ravana play. Okay, Ravana has to come and kidnap Sita only. It's his role. No, I won't kidnap Sita. Okay, Rama, you go. The play will be spoiled. Your boss has to shout. And you have to understand, it's his play, his role, his dialogue is that much only. You have to say your dialogue. So the moment you start forgetting that it's a role playing, you start getting stressed. Okay. So this is not just theory. We'll see how to go back to my real self. Right?
What about the damage that already has been done?
That is a part of the old part of the story of the drama. Now next scene you have come.
New director has come.
New director has come. Right? So accept what? Who said this? Accept?
Myself.
Huh, what is this acceptance?
Acceptance is whatever situation comes to us, we have to accept so that we will be happy.
Do you have a choice not to accept? Any time in life?
Yeah, it brings suffering. If I don't.
So, you don't want suffering?
No.
Accept. See, life, whatever we say, life doesn't give us choice, right? This, we have a choice of suffering or not suffering.
Yeah.
If you reject this is choice, suffering. Mm-hmm. If you accept, there's no suffering.
True.
Right? It is not a big complicated game. Suppose some situation comes in your life, very unfavorable. Example. Right? Do you have a choice of not accepting it? Life doesn't give you a choice. Nobody gets a choice in life, right? Right? Rama, for Rama also Sita was kidnapped. There's no choice. Okay. So there's no choice for anybody in life. Situations come, good situation, bad situation. Okay? But there's a choice in suffering. Right? Life doesn't give you a choice. But you can make a choice in suffering or not suffering. Are you getting what I'm saying?
Yes.
How do you make a choice in suffering or not suffering?
Just
first thing is accept. Okay? Anything in life, I accept. Okay. How can you accept bad thing in life? Good thing in life, I definitely accept. I'll accept, accept, accept.
Situation comes, we have to accept.
Right.
Yes.
And if you accept, there's no suffering.
We have to accept.
We have to accept is no choice,
yes,
right?
Yes.
And the moment you accept is no suffering. Correct? So why we have to suffer in life?
There will be no suffering if you accept.
So the suffering is your choice. Okay. But situation in life is not your choice. Am I making clear?
Yes.
Right? Tomorrow something happens. Tomorrow this rain or sunshine.
Daily one problem.
One problem is there. But you don't have a choice in situation.
Yeah.
But you have a choice in not suffering. The not suffering can be done only when you accept. The moment you accept, there's like peace in life.
Every second problem.
Yes. But why we don't accept, I'll tell you. Right? Why we don't accept, I'll tell you. There is a secret for that, not accepting. Right? So tell me, the fire is there. You put your hand into the fire. Fire burns.
Yeah.
Okay? So do you say it's bad fire?
No. Huh? Nature of the fire is
nature
of the fire is to burn. Right?
Yeah.
But you don't complain the fire is burning?
No.
No, no?
No.
It's our fault only.
Huh?
We keep our hand.
Huh. So you say fire, you never complain against fire, right? No complaints.
No complaint.
Huh?
No
complaint. Okay? So snake comes. It bites. So you say it's a bad snake?
No.
It's nature.
Yeah, that's nature.
Okay. So we accept everything in life, what is nature, without any complaint. Right? So fire's nature is burn, accepted. Snake's nature is to bite, accepted. No complaint. But my husband should be not like this. My wife should not be like this. Right? My job should not be like this. So we have always a complaint because we don't accept it as the nature of the things. Somewhere we want a modification. Clear? Why are you not able to accept everything in life as nature of things? The moment you say it's nature of thing, you'll get a peace.
Fire burns. If it burns our property,
a
car.
Yeah, but do you have a complaint that fire? I mean, you say.
It's not complaining about the fire. It's complaining about.
Yeah, you can, you have to take care of that, right? But you don't. There's no situation. The nature of fire, you don't accept. Fire nature is accepted as fire burning. But have you accepted the nature of your husband? You want improvement, no? Every year he has to be in quality improvement program.
Not just the improvement, it should remain stable.
It should remain stable also. So, this is the situation. We don't accept, okay, human nature. Okay? The human nature is as it is. you have to accept there are three types of nature, sattvaguna, rajoguna, tamoguna. Their behavior is like that. You cannot complain about a fire being hot. Right? Accept the nature of things as it is, you'll have peace. Are you able to accept?
Sometimes yes, sometimes no.
But the question is, why no?
Because we don't like that.
Ah, so the question is, like and like, dislike came, then you means you don't accept. The moment you didn't accept, you have chosen suffering. Then you can't complain for suffering to the other person. Because of you, I suffered. You chose the suffering. Huh? When you made a choice of suffering, why? How the other person is responsible? Am I making sense, sir?
Yes.
Huh? Yes or no?
Yes.
Then where is the question of suffering? So acceptance is not a choice actually. Acceptance is a way of life. You can try to accept and then improve the situation. But not accepting something and crying every day. Yeah, my job is like that. I cry every day. What is the point? The nature of your job is working for 12 hours a day. That's the nature. Accept over. That is nature. Now either you change the job, okay, or accept the nature of the job and be peaceful. You cannot say, I am stressful because of job. Right? So the nature of life is, accept, change what you can. Right? Can you repeat with me? Change what you can. Try harder and change what you can. Accept what you can't. Be peaceful after that. Don't be complaining every day. It is not worth it. Right? Every day you cannot keep telling your job.
Right.
Decide. Either this job is like that, I will do, and I like jobs. Or say, no, this job is not for me, find something else. But you cannot do both. Cry and do.
Not body, mind.
Yeah. Not body, mind, intellect. True nature. We'll find out what is the true nature.
Ups and downs.
Ups and downs. Yes, we have discussed. No satisfaction. Why there is no satisfaction in life? Please tell me. Why I am not satisfied in life?
Because you want more.
Ah, I want more. Why? Why I want more?
You live happily.
What is that more?
Greed.
See, what is need? How much is need and how much is greed? Where is the line? Who draws the line? What is the need and what is greed?
We should know.
So, satisfaction is a choice or in the situation?
Situation.
You have to draw a line. This is what my situation. Why? The moment you are not satisfied, okay?
Resistance.
You have to start working more for it. See, for example, I got a car. What is it? A Maruti car. My neighbor bought a Skoda car. Okay? I am unhappy. Right? Nothing wrong in being unhappy. I am not satisfied. So, only thing is, I have to work 3 years more to get a Skoda. So the question is, you have to ask is, with 3 years more working worth my retirement, I have to postpone by 3 years. So is it worth? So everything in life has a value to be paid. Right? Eating more is very nice. But you have to pay for it.
Right.
How?
After that some disease.
Okay? After that, lot of exercise, right? So everything has a pay price. So when you say what I am paying and what I am getting, is it worth it? Then you know what is need and what is greed.
Where do you draw a line?
No,
no satisfaction. True identity you will find out.
Present.
Okay. Being in present. We'll come to that. Okay? So now we'll go to next this class. Try to answer these questions. What is your true identity? Now all of you have come here. What is true identity, sir? Do you know? You have heard I am the self and all. Right? All spiritual literature. But really do tell me one point of your time in life. You are your true self. You are blissful. Tell me, remember your whole history of, let's say, 40 years, 30 years, or 50 years. Tell me, this point of time, I was my true self. I was blissful. Okay? Just close your eyes, recollect that, and tell. Recollect a time, a point of time in your life when you are self, your true self, and blissful. No. No. So fine. Anybody has an answer?
No.
In your whole life,
no.
You have to tell, I was blissful when? The sentence you complete.
When I was playing with my son, there's no past or present at that time.
So, when I was playing with my son. Right. Okay. There is this sentence, right? When I was playing with my son. Right?
That was the present moment, so there was no
past. So, I was blissful and I'm myself now, and then?
Huh?
I was myself, true self?
There was nothing, yeah.
Yeah, okay. So, anybody else?
Being with nature.
Being with nature.
Listening to a nice song.
Okay.
Attend
nice song? Yeah. So, attending classes. Anybody else?
I am going mother house.
You are going to your parents' house?
Parents' house.
Going to parents' house? Thaurmane. Next. Anybody else?
Deep sleep.
Shashidhar? Money.
Getting more orders in the
very blissful when I took that hot water bath in
Badrinath. Oh, Badrinath hot water bath, okay.
I told you.
Okay, Badrinath hot water bath.
Whenever there is no eye, there is peace.
Water bath. Anybody else has any more additions? What about you?
I don't know whether it is bliss or not. There have been moments wherein I have been happy, that moment.
Okay, moment of happiness.
Yes.
Madam, you?
When I was in Kashi, sir, we were there for 10 days.
Ah, Kashi. Okay, now all of you have a solution now. Okay? So, to be blissful, don't come to Atmadhyana class. Take a house in Kashi. Sir, stay in Badri.
forever.
Don't come back. Anyway, you are blissful now. Ultimately, you are looking for blissful in life. What is first one?
Play with the child.
Don't do anything.
Attending class also.
So, we cannot make it residential, okay? So, playing with the child, you do all the time playing with the child. Okay, then?
Visiting
parents. Stay there, madam. Then they'll say, no, when are you going back, madam? Okay.
No back.
Okay.
So then?
Sleep, sir.
24 hours.
That's why the best man in the history of humankind is called Kumbhakarna. 6 months blissful. Right? Then what? Kashi Yatra. Take a home in Kashi. Simple. What about you?
I don't know, this passing moment, sometimes maybe with nature or when I'm all also, sometimes I cannot tell.
Okay, sometimes nature, okay. So now please understand what you are doing.
everything you have put is a condition. And the conditions which you have put are unsatisfactory, cannot be satisfied at all. You understand? If you say, I am blissful, if I am attending a discourse, then you have to attend the discourse all the time.
That's an art architect.
So the conditions apply, okay, makes you miserable. Can you be blissful without conditions apply? You understood?
Yeah.
How?
But then it's not in our hands really. It just comes and it goes.
What comes and goes is not called bliss. What comes goes also, it's called happiness. Okay, what comes and goes is not bliss, it's called happiness. Okay, so many times we are confusing happiness with the bliss. Bliss doesn't come and go, happiness comes and goes. Happiness is one ray of bliss. If bliss is this much, happiness is one ray. So all your life you are confusing happiness with the bliss.
Passing cloud.
So you are confusing happiness with the bliss and you are on the wrong track. Bliss doesn't come and go. That's called bliss. Permanent. Happiness comes and goes. Okay. And happiness can always be purchased. Bliss cannot be purchased. How? Badrinath ticket can be purchased. Okay, Kashi Yatra ticket can be purchased. Taurmani ticket can be purchased. What else?
Listening to songs.
Sir, you should always have an ear implant. Nowadays they can do microsurgery. Put one. Blissful all the time, no?
That only is for half an hour.
So, please understand what you are speaking is nothing to do with bliss. Okay? You have no clue about bliss. And what is this bliss you are seeking? You are speaking of spirituality and bliss and all. What is this?
That's what we want to know.
How can you know something which you don't know? You can know something. If I say, okay, there is a monkey, immediately monkey you know, because you know how you see the monkey. If I say there is an elephant called Jim 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 in Africa, what do you know? Nothing, can't understand. You cannot know bliss if you don't, you have not experienced bliss. Right? If you are not experienced bliss, you will not know bliss. Then what are you seeking? What you are not experiencing? Huh?
One ray.
Of course.
At least one ray.
One ray. Right? So now you write down. Yes, erase this and write down.
One ray.
So bliss is something infinite. Bliss is something which is permanent. It doesn't come and go. Okay? Bliss is not purchasable. Even if you have pain in the body, the bliss doesn't come and go. The bliss is not dependent on time, space, or situation. That is called bliss. You want that? It's quite expensive. Okay?
Is it present all the time?
Yeah.
Yes. So if it's present sometime and going, it's called happiness. Okay? Because we don't know what we are seeking, we confuse something and get mixed up with something else.
Someone is meditating, so mind becomes silent or something. So that is also part of happiness.
That is the happiness you experienced. One small part of the bliss you experienced. One ray of bliss.
One ray of bliss. Because it's gone.
Clear? The bliss doesn't come and doesn't go. How many of you want that now? It's quite expensive, okay? Quite expensive.
Now we can't be happy with happiness also.
Can't be happy with happiness also. So, you have to understand the difference between the pleasure, happiness, joy and bliss. Pleasure means sense organs. Massage. Pleasant massage. you can say pleasure. Right? Pleasure. Very massage. Somebody is giving pleasure. Nice. Okay. Body related. It's called pleasure.
Our headache will go.
Now, the pleasure has a counterpart, has a companion, wife. What is it called?
Pain.
They come in pairs. They don't come single. So if you ask for pleasure, the pain will come. Sometime or later. Okay? The pleasure and pain, both are one small, pleasure is one small ray of bliss. Bliss appearing temporarily is called pleasure. Small. Okay? So that's called body. For a mind, it's called happiness and unhappiness. Right? So the pleasure for the body when you make a physical contact, a cup of coffee in the morning is very pleasant. Right? Tea is very pleasant. A contact has to be made with the object. Right? The mental contact is called happiness. Friend is not there. Oh, my friend, my childhood friend. Remember that friend. Childhood friend is already gone. You make a mental contact with a friend. Physical, not physical. So the mental contact gives happiness. It's not physical now. Physical also gives happiness. But mental contact is happiness. And what is the counterpart of that?
Unhappiness.
Unhappiness. Right? So if there's a mountain, there's a valley. There's a law of nature. Okay? You cannot get only mountain. The mountain has to come with the valley. Pleasure will come with the pain. Happiness will come with the unhappiness. What about joy?
Sorrow.
Joy is coming in sorrow. Right? Pleasure and pain are related to, pleasure is related to body. Happiness is related to mind. Sorrow is related to soul.
Sad.
Somebody became depressed. Depression. Now no conditions apply. He got a money and depressed. He lost money, depressed. Got a job, depressed. Got married, depressed. So whatever is pleasure and pain has gone deep inside. Right? Somebody is always elated. Okay, chalta hai jindagi, or is bindas life. So that's called soul. Okay, now your joy, even the depressed guy, joy, depressed guy also can feel little bit of happiness somewhere. It also can come. But bliss is not related to that. Bliss is related to Atma.
Soul and Atma.
No, soul means Jiva. Jiva. Atma is bliss. It has never come, never gone. Then what to do for that?
Take out the others.
Confusion with others has to be reduced. Recognize what is there. Okay, you cannot get Atma because you are already Atma. So you start recognizing the self, then bliss is your nature. Now, where you miss the bliss, you'll find out. Missing the bliss, how do you find out? We'll find out. Where did you miss the bliss?
Bliss is nothing but peace then.
We'll find out, no? I'll tell you what is bliss. We'll see. What is it? Yeah. Consider. So happiness is pleasure is related to body, happiness is related to mind, sorrow and joy is related to individual, and bliss is related to self. Why is this stuck?
No.
This control or del?
Control?
All del.
Del.
Task manager.
Use the arrows.
You go, you go for a break, okay? Go for a to go to a restroom and have a cup of coffee and set up. Something is wrong here. Stuck.
Switch it off and switch it off.
Yeah, I'll do it.